connection between diabetics and complications with COVID-19.
Yeah, this was really interesting. It was a study done in France, and they were looking at patients with diabetes, both types, type 1 and type 2, because usually when we hear the word diabetes without even saying it, we're really kind of dealing with the people with type 2 diabetes. But this study in France found that 1 in 10 patients with diabetes died in the first 7 days after hospitalization for COVID-19. 1 in 5 patients with diabetes needed ventilatory support in terms of breathing. They need to be put on a ventilator. In terms of this group, they found higher rates of death with men with diabetes, with obese men with diabetes, and with diabetes alone. And they teased it out, 89% had type 2 diabetes, 3% had type 1 diabetes. And again, the thinking is that just having diabetes can alter our immune response, our basic inflammation level, which may then interact with COVID-19. And so learning more about this population, really, really important, because we've known really from the beginning that they're at much higher risk.
And so you always say it's important to know how you can use results. So what can we do about
exactly? And so I think one of the hopes or directions in the future is that if you really understand how high risk this group is, then could they be screened differently? Could they get aggressive treatment that differs from patients who don't have diabetes? That's the key in medicine. Once you make that observation, tailoring it to actually improve clinical outcomes.
Right, from the onset when they walk in, if they know they're diabetic, maybe there could be a more aggressive form of
treatment
from the beginning.
Exactly. That's the hope.
All right, Dr.